So, hello everyone, my name is Simon Resch. I'm a Tableau Solution Engineer. I recently joined Tableau, and before that I was working at SAP themselves. And I'm now part of a team that is developing together with Accenture a new demo and also some go-to-market material. And I want to give you today an overview of why SAP is very important for Tableau and Accenture right now. Also, how Tableau can be best deployed on SAP. And additionally, I want to give you a sneak preview of how you can use Tableau on top of SAP data with a sneak preview of our demo that we have prepared or that we will finish by the end of May. All right. So at the moment, many SAP customers, they are forced to rethink their SAP strategy because SAP has a lot of changes that are ongoing in their product portfolio. Most importantly, the main SAP ERP solution called SAP Business Suite that will go into its end of maintenance until the end of 2027. And that is forcing SAP's large enterprise resource customers, customer base, to migrate to more modern, newer solutions. In particular, this will be for most customers, the S/4HANA system. Additionally, SAP has a large footprint in the data warehouse market with its sub BW system, Business Warehouse. And those 16,000 BW customers that SAP has, they are also being urged to migrate from existing traditional databases like DB2, for example, to more modern databases, in particular to SAP HANA. And SAP W4HANA is currently marketing for their customers. Then we have, as an additional big change in the SAP portfolio, we have SAP moving away from a lot of the traditional business objects tools that they have offered before, and now they are focusing on only one SAP Analytics solution, which is a pure cloud-based analytics solution called SAP Analytics Cloud. And they are also trying to move their customers away from these traditional BI solutions. And due to these three big shifts in the SAP portfolio, it's also giving Tableau and Accenture a big chance in being part of this discussion and to position also Tableau as an additional tool in this scenario. To emphasize this with a few numbers, the German-speaking SAP group, DESAG, they have published a survey that they did amongst their participants. And the result is that 72% of the big companies that are using SAP, they are planning to migrate to S/4HANA. And only a very low number of customers are already using S/4HANA. And another even lower number is deciding against moving to this more modern ERP system. So the large majority of customers is going this way of going to S/4HANA, and they're not yet there. So they are now planning this transition, and we should be part of this transition. When it comes to analytics on top of SAP data, many customers, they're thinking in the first place just inside the SAP own ecosystem. So they might be thinking about SAP Analytics Cloud as an analytics tool. But our focus is now to bring Tableau also in the talks and to show them that they can use the one of the overall market leaders in terms of analytics on top of SAP data. Benefit overall from using Tableau also on top of their SAP data. And in order to start this discussion and in order to successfully convince these customers that Tableau is the best solution on top of SAP data, we have some ongoing investments. So first and foremost, we have done lots of improvements to our SAP connectors, particularly the SAP HANA, very strategic for Tableau. And we have done various improvements for this connector. So one example is the support of SAP HANA's level hierarchies. Then we have done a lot of performance improvements. For example, you can use now parameter binding inside Tableau, and you can make use of the shared metadata cache even when you're using a single sign-on. Then Tableau is now also an officially certified SAP HANA partner, and Tableau Desktop and Tableau Prep are already now certified by SAP, and very soon Tableau Server and Tableau Online will also follow. And there have been these are just examples. So there have been a lot of additional improvements that did come for our connectors, just to show you that we are actively working on making our already superb connector even better.
Simon, is the certification very recent?
Yes, it's very recent. Indeed, it's this month.
Okay, that's why. So I think if this is important, so I think we can start socializing this to our customers, right? So if you have any communication or details around that as to what exact certifications those are, please share that with the group.
Sure. So I have here in the slides a link. You will receive the slides later on, I guess. Met with
thanks.
Them. And then you can follow this link and will point directly to an SAP page where you will see that Tableau is being certified and you will see some more details about this.
Excellent. Thanks.
Yeah, you're welcome. Additionally, we have started a development project together with Accenture. And Accenture has helped setting up for Tableau a development environment that includes an S4HANA system, also a BW4HANA system, so the top-notch SAP products. And we are using this now and with our development to further improve our connectors. And we have now also very relevant test data in it. So this will lead to even better connectors in the future. Additionally, we are right now in the progress of creating lots of enablement assets, in particular go-to-market assets, that will help us communicate our value for the customers, and also it will help our customers making the best use of Tableau on top of their SAP data. So one of these assets is a new demo scenario that is being created right now. It is on top of SAP data that originates from S4HANA. This will be sales data, accounts receivable data, and P&L data. Later on in this presentation, I will show you some wireframes, some screenshots of the accounts receivables demo that we are preparing. Then we will have some guidance regarding the use of Tableau in S4HANA analytics, in the sense of what is the best practice of how you can connect to S4HANA data, and these kind of topics. Then we will have additional and enhanced of how to use Tableau on top of SAP data. And we will have best practice documents that will outline details, for example, how you can connect to BW4HANA using the SAP HANA connector and using exposed HANA views that are based on BW objects, how you can develop the HANA security in this scenario, how you can flatten a parent-child hierarchy in HANA so you can consume it using the leveled hierarchy connector in Tableau. So for these very technical details, we will then have better documentations. So you can better understand on how to enable this. And finally, we will also have lots of visualization tool assessment documents. In particular, we are comparing the SAP connectivity of Tableau to the SAP connectivity that ThoughtSpot, Qlik, Spotfire, Looker, SAP Analytics Cloud, and also Power BI are offering. And these kind of documents, they're also right now in the making. Finally, one of the overall goals is that once our demo on top of the SAP data is done, we will also try to integrate this part into our overall Enterprise 360 demo that John has just demonstrated to you. So we can make this SAP part of this demo even better. Why is this important for Accenture? The SAP arm of Accenture is one of the largest revenue drivers for Accenture. It has over $5 billion in revenue. And as we can see in the Gartner Magic Quadrant, Accenture is the clear leader when it comes to SAP consulting, SAP application services. And that shows that it was for us an easy decision to partner with Accenture and to have Accenture help us how to further improve our connectors and how to improve our go-to-market material. Tableau and Accenture have both analyzed their, and both companies have looked at what are their focus customers, and we have come up with a list of focus customers in EMEA that are Tableau focus customers, but also customers that Accenture is already helping in their S4HANA migration, on their S4HANA journey. So these are customers that that should focus on having Tableau integrated in their S4HANA journey. Now I want to show you finally some screenshots of the demo that will be finished by end of May. And just to tease you a little bit on how you can use Tableau on top of SAP data. First, to better understand the demo scenario or landscape, the data that we're using for our demo, it originates in S4HANA system. S4HANA is the data source. Then the data is extracted using BW extractors from SAP, which is a very common approach at customers, to a standalone data warehouse, which is the BW4HANA 2.0 data warehouse, so the modern SAP on-premise data warehouse. And then we are exposing this data to Tableau using the SAP HANA SQL connector that Tableau offers. This is an example of the demo scenario is that I'm a financial accountant and I want to analyze accounts receivable receivable data. So when I open this dashboard, I get a nice overview with some of the most important KPIs. For example, the outstanding total amount of dollars that my customers are owing me, the amount that the customers are overdue already, how large this proportion is out of my total outstanding amount. I'll see the total amount of invoices, the amount of overdue invoices. I can see on the left in an aging bucket, I can identify very quickly how much of these amounts are not yet due, how much are overdue for like a short amount of time, like 30 days, all using these kind of buckets, aging buckets. And then if we look on the right, we have an overview of our top customers that are contributing to these outstanding amounts and these open balances. And I can't show it right now because it's a screenshot, but if you click on these customers, you can drill down and you can see for these customers how the figures are looking. And on the bottom left, you can see in chart, which is the accounts receivable trend, and you can see the open balance, so the overdue amounts, outstanding amounts, throughout time for the last complete full year and also for the current year and the current months that we already have, the first 4 months of the year. And once you click on one of these months, you can drill down in the next view, and there you will drill deeper into the data. You can see for those invoices, in this example, I clicked on April. I can see that those invoices in April, most of them are due in June, some already in May, and very few latest in July. I can see what's the total outstanding amount again, and also have a nice overview of the amount of invoices, how many of those are already overdue, which is just one because it's April, so this one has probably just a very short payment term. We have a nice overdue density chart on the bottom, which helps to very visually show how long our overdue days are, how long in the past, and how the values are distributing across these days. And again, we have a custom heat map on the right, which shows what are the most relevant customers for that particular month. And in this example, we can see that Cityscape Cycles is the customer that has contributed the most with the outstanding amounts. So if I want to see more what's happening with this customer, I can just click on this customer and I can drill deeper. And this view is then the customer analysis, and it will show for that particular customer we selected, how is their debt and payment trend in the past. We can see that here on the left. And there we can see that for this particular customer, the customer was very bad in terms of paying our debts in 2017, 2018. Then during 2019, this customer did a good job in paying us on time and improved its open balance. But then in 2020, he started to collect again a large balance of outstanding amounts. We can see the running sum of the balance since the start of our data story, since 2017, how this developed. And also we can, if we click on particular months, we can drill down deeper into that month again and filter the charts on this page. And we have here an overview again on the closed invoice aging. So we can see what is the average payment term, what's the average overdue days, and details like this. And if we have identified an issue with a customer that is not paying us in time, then we have directly the contact details here. So I, as a financial analyst or accountant, I can directly contact our contact person and ask them to do a better job in paying us on time. For the quick overview of as I already said, this demo is in the making, it's a work in progress, and we're aiming to have it finalized by the end of May.
Right.